to pay attention to this, including the employers, because this lady has some good information, okay? And you want to know about good information. So this is Jennifer Gonzalez. She's from the Department of Labor. And she's going to talk to you about all types of incentives that they have for seniors who are employed and for employers that employ seniors. And some other things.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Jennifer Gonzalez, and I'm a Special Populations Opportunity Developer with the Department of Labor and Workforce Development. We have a variety of talent pools for new employer partners that we're interested in working with, and we have people who are unemployed, individuals that are looking for work, and are able to help you with all of your talent management needs. We also have people that may be in this very room that are part of our different programs. If you hire anybody out of our special populations and other programs, employers have the opportunity to receive 50% salary reimbursement. I'm going to repeat that. 50% salary reimbursement for the employee's gross wages under the OJT, which is called on-the-job training program. For example, if anybody here, job seeker, if anybody here is currently receiving anything under the Workforce New Jersey subsidy, which would be TANF, General Assistance, or SNAP, which is food stamp, the employer would be able to receive 50% reimbursement for hiring you. So that's an incentive that you guys can use as well. And with the Workforce New Jersey program employers, there is no cap. So if you have a supervisor or director type of position, we can reimburse you 50% there, where all the rest of the OJTs are capped at $10,000. Anyone who is currently receiving unemployment benefits in the room, or if anybody has exhausted their benefits in the last 52 weeks, or anybody here is receiving Workforce New Jersey, which is people receiving subsidies under General Assistance, TANF, Temporary Assistance for Needy Families, or SNAP, which is Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program, another name for food stamp. That means any employer that hires you, the contract has to be in place prior to them hiring you. But anybody that hires you, we will reimburse 50% of your gross salary. That is the only OJT that there is no cap at. We can give you over the $10,000, where the rest of the programs are capped at $10,000. If anybody is currently receiving unemployment benefits or has exhausted those benefits in the last 52 weeks, or anybody who is part of our DVR, Division of Vocational Rehabilitation Program, or if there's anybody in here who is part of our PEP program, the Parolee Employment Placement Program, we will be able to give an OJT contract to the employer who hires you, where we reimburse 50% of your gross salary, and that goes up to 6 months, which is 26 weeks. On top of that, the employers also have the opportunity to apply for work opportunity tax credits, and I would be glad to share those individually with anybody who is interested. We also have an OJE, on the job experience program. If anybody here is a non-for-profit company, we have not only the OJE, but we have CWEP, Community Workforce Experience Program, where you would be able to have people come work and they get the experience with you, and we take care of the cost for the salary on that. We also have an OJE program for for-profit companies. With the for-profit company, we will take care of the salary and the workers' comp for the 55 plus mature workers program for the first 4 weeks of their employment with you, as well as the workers' comp, if I didn't mention that. If you choose anyone from one of our programs, all employers can receive what's called federal bonding. With federal bonding, that covers anybody who's economically disadvantaged. So that covers anybody who has poor credit. And job seekers here, you want to pay attention to this too, because you can have this opportunity as well when you're presenting to your employer during interviews. It covers anybody who has looks like they're a job hopper or lacking work history. It covers anybody who's an ex-substance abuser. It also covers anybody who's an ex-felon. And this basically is an insurance that states that you were honest, okay? So this goes for 6 months free for the employer. There's no cost, no deductible to you or the employee. And the good thing basically is if there's anybody you feel might be a little bit of a risk to hire, take a chance, because we're gonna cover you on top of your salary reimbursement or OJT contract, we're gonna cover you with the federal bonding as well. And anybody who's interested, employers or job seekers, if you're interested, you're welcome to reach out to me and I can connect you with the appropriate person through the Department of Labor. We also have, we participate with what's called talent industry or talent networks. I'm not sure if any of the employer partners here are already a part of that. There are 7 different sector industries, and I would be happy to connect you and give you the opportunity not only to stand out as an industry leader, but you get the opportunity to share insights and sharing your hiring trends, your talent gap, your skill and your competency needs. You're advocating for, we advocate for your policies, practices, legislation, and basically it helps to increase your opportunities for resources and qualified workers here in our good state of New Jersey. Also, under the new legislation under WIOA, Workforce Innovation Opportunity Act, that basically states that everything is customer-driven all around the employer. So whatever the employer needs, that's what we're looking for. Also, if any of our employer partners in the room are interested in learning more, please provide me with your business card, and I would be happy to arrange a time to come out and present to you, bring some marketing material, and go over not only the information that I shared, but we also have customized training opportunities where you may be able to qualify. They're all competitive, but you may be able to qualify for training grants through the Department of Labor as well. And I also must mention, we have everyone from low skill all the way up to very high skilled people. I've placed people that were doing porter and fast food positions all the way up into executive management who are under these OJT and OJE opportunities as well. My team and I are looking forward to working with everybody here, and we're dedicated to delivering exceptional customer service and satisfaction. And thank you so much for allowing me to speak today.
Thank you, David. Turn the mic up. So. Okay, that was some awesome information, wasn't it? And maybe after, I'm going to let the mayor speak. Maybe if we have questions, I will allow people to ask questions. But right now, I'd like to introduce our mayor, Mayor Lester E. Taylor. This is his brainchild. This initiative for the senior workforce was something that he asked me to develop, and I must say it has turned out to be awesome. So, without further ado, Mayor Lester E. Taylor.
Thank you, Ms. Johnson. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
First, let me say how excited but also humbled I am to see so many eager faces in this room looking for employment opportunities. You know, normally as a mayor, when we have these types of seminars, it's for our teenagers or for some of our young adults looking to get into the workforce. But it's so great to see so many of you looking at it to get back into the workforce. To our representative from the Department of Labor, thank you so much for coming here to East Orange. We are looking to positively contribute and affect the unemployment rate in our community. And it starts from people who are 14 and 15, all the way up to people who are seniors. We are looking to positively change their lives and help those in the middle class and the working class to strengthen our families in our community. And one thing that we notice is that many of our seniors are still raising their families, whether it be their children, their grandchildren, other extended family. And so with all due respect to Ms. Johns, and I thank her for her commitment and her diligence in helping make this program grow, I can't take credit for this, because this idea was actually my wife's. Bibi had this idea, so thank her. Clap for Bibi, please, so I can tell y'all clap. But it was her idea. We were sitting down last year trying to think of what we could do better, what we could do to help more people in the city of East Orange. And we thought about, when we come to this building and we see the Silver Steppers dancing. We see Rick Clark torturing y'all with the exercise program. We see all the energy that's bursting through the seams in this building. We said we need to put them to work. But then the flip side is, when I sat there the first year we had the seminar, I said, no good deed goes unpunished, because we likely have more people than jobs. And so I challenged Ms. Johns to reach out to the Department of Labor, to reach out to some of our area businesses, to extend to them the opportunity to get qualified and competent, hardworking people. And so I thank all the different businesses who are here, those who aren't here, they're going to provide opportunities for you to work, for you to earn some extra money, for you to stay active and work with us in the city of East Orange as we work every day to set the standard for urban excellence and make East Orange a destination city. I see. Thank you. I see Councilwoman Paula Talmadge has just joined us. I want her to please come up and say a few words. And again, I thank everyone for coming out. I hope and pray that we can place everybody. And if we can't, don't get mad. We're going to try harder to do it next year because Home Depot got a lot more money than East Orange has. All right? And so we'll make sure that we put you in all their locations. I'm just picking on you, Home Depot. But it's something that we're working diligently for. We have so much happening in East Orange right now. We have about $400 million of private investment happening. So we're building new businesses, new places to live and work right here in our city. And so the opportunities will be coming in the years to come. Thank you all, and God bless you.
Thank you, Mayor. Good morning, everyone. It's such a beautiful crowd, and I'm hoping, as the mayor said, that each and every one of you land the job, the part-time job that you've been looking for. I'd just like to thank LaDonna and her staff for doing such a great job with the Mayor's Office of Employment Training. The mayor for his vision, and this is part of his vision of making East Orange a destination city. And you can well see that we're on our way. There's so much happening in the city right now, and I'm just so proud of the work that the mayor and his administration is doing. And we're going to continue to do the great work and service all of you. So you have a good day and good luck to every one of you. Thank you.
Flight controllers here looking very carefully at the situation. Obviously a major malfunction.
Your love is bright as ever, even in the shadows. Baby, kiss me before they turn the lights out. Your heart is glowing, and I'm crashing into you. Baby, kiss me before they turn the lights out. Before they turn the lights out. Run now, yeah. Nobody's